Alright everyone, Cody here, and today I broke a socket extension while trying to take a tire off of a backhoe. See, I probably had about 1,000 foot-pounds of torque on there when it broke, and I'd like to fix it to such an extent that it can handle about 1,000 foot-pounds again. Now, you could try welding this with an arc welder. I've done that before. But it just never holds. So I'm going to try doing this with thermite. So let's make up some thermite. And see if we can do that. Alright, here's the iron oxide. I've got some borax, potassium dichromate, and some graphite here as additives. This is the aluminum I'm using. You can see here, it's fairly fine. I made it myself by taking an aluminum rod such as this. I turned it down in the lathe into little aluminum chips, and I threw those in a ball mill overnight, and this is the result. I'm going to go ahead and put this in with the iron oxide here. There you are. Go ahead and mix that up, and I'll have my thermite. Alright, now that I got that mixed up, I'm going to go ahead and test it to make sure it works properly by putting a little bit inside of an eggshell in the ashes there. And I'm going to go ahead and light it, see how it does. Alright. Got my match ready. There we are. You didn't see much, did you? I think that stuff will work just fine. I've let it cool naturally, how I would have it cool inside the mold, and then we'll test its hardness. There it is. I fished the sample out of the ashes. Now we're ready to break away from the slag and see how it looks. There's our button of metal. It looks good. There's no bubbles. I can already tell it's pretty strong. It doesn't shatter or anything. Yeah, hit it as hard as I like. I can't dent it. So I think that's pretty good. I think the alloy is just what I need. Alright, let's see if we can weld that wrench. Here's my mold. You can see I've got the tool in there. You can see it down in there. A little bit of a gap at the bottom of this mold, which is made out of sand and clay. You can probably see it better on this side. The idea is to fill this cavity up with thermite, and when it burns, it'll make molten metal. It'll go down and try to come out this hole. That way it'll give a good bond, and perhaps melt that in with it and give a good weld. So I'm going to put in a piece of aluminum foil here just to stop it from falling down just yet. So I want the thermite to be well and reacted before it comes in contact with the steel. So let's put the thermite in now, shall we? Alright, there's the thermite. Hopefully it's enough. Go ahead and touch it off. I'm going to use a blowtorch to ignite it. Fingers crossed. Torch on. Ironically, a match actually works better sometimes. Come on. There we go. Whoa, that's hot. There's the molten metal. Whoa. Look at that smoke. Oh, that was... I should not have been standing that close. Okay. I'm alright. But, wow. That was a lot of heat. I think it turned most of the sand into glass right there. It's still too hot to get near it. A lot of the thermite actually splashed out. I don't know if you can see. It's kind of weird. Alright, I'm going to let that cool off naturally, and then probably half an hour I'll break open the mold and see what it looks like. Alright, here it is. I think it's mostly cooled off now. Still feels warm, but I think for the most part it's not glowing anymore. Let's go ahead and break it open, shall we? I'm very curious to see what happened. I can see it got that thing kind of hot. Is that metal or slag? You know what? It didn't weld it. Not at all. Look at that. Damn it. Well, what did it do in there? I guess I will have to arc weld them together. Yeah, look. It's a big lump of steel there. Bunch of slag. Well, that's disappointing. It was kind of cool to make, though. Yeah, what I'm going to do then, I guess, is go ahead and grind that. I mean, it did melt it a little bit, but just it didn't flow in and melt it enough. But yeah, what I plan to do is grind it out, bevel it, and then just weld it with a regular arc welder. I mean, that does work, it just won't be as good as it was before. As for this piece of very hot, high carbon steel, I think I'm going to make a knife out of it. Something like that, I guess. I mean, it's some pretty good steel. Alright, well. Hope you enjoyed that. I'll see you next time.